Good afternoon and welcome to America's Home Cooking. Today I'm going to make a strawberry pie. Now this is a newer recipe than from the 1950s, but they do not teach you that you have to put wax paper on the bottom inside before you do the crust. What they just read is fit into a 9-inch pie pan, trim overhead, make a decorative edge, and prick the dough with a fork. No, there's a step that they're leaving out. The old people, like me, or from the old class, we know that you have to sit there and get a 9-inch pie. Well, I'm making a 9-inch, so I'm going to need a 9-inch pie plate. And we have to line it on the bottom with wax paper so the crust doesn't stick. These are things that they're not teaching you anymore in the recipes. They assume that you already know it. I was talking to a lady who's younger than me, and she was telling me, yeah, we had home ec, they taught us how to make candy and stuff, but they didn't teach them the basics of things that they needed to learn. So what you do is you get a wax paper. Remember, you measure the inside top here for a 9-inch. That's the real measure. You put it down the wax paper, you take a pencil, and go around in a circle, right on the edge, as close as you can, on the inside. Cut it out and you lay it in there. I was eating blueberries. I have them stuck to my tooth. This is a trick that you need to know. That before you put the crust in, you must line it with wax paper or it will stick. A lot of these old tricks that women have learned through the years are now being left out, and people don't know, and they get discouraged, and they don't think that they can cook, or they can't do things. And if you don't learn the basics of these things, it gives you a hard time in the kitchen. Then you feel like a failure. You don't need to feel like a failure. It's just that they're not teaching you everything you need to know. So I take the extra time, who's ever watching, that you learn these tricks that I was taught that helps me in my baking, that I learned from Julia Child, I'm bringing to you, and that the older women taught me a lot about, okay? So once you cut it out, put it in there, and we're going to put this to the side because we're going to make the crust, and the crust is going to sit in saran wrap. I know it as plastic wrap. No, you know it better as plastic wrap, but I knew it as saran wrap. That's what we used to call it when I was younger. How much flour is it going to be called for? 1 cup, so I can use a smaller one. Now, a pastry cutter is very important in your kitchen. They don't always come in this shape, but you can get them in different shapes. And what they do is they cut the shortening into the flour till it's really flaky and in small pieces. So when you bake your crust, you get that nice flaky taste. You know, when you cut into it, it's not packed and heavy. It cuts and it just starts to fall apart. That's because it's got a lot of the layers of shortening flour, and that's why you use it. So let me get some measuring cups out. We need 1 cup. Oh, I'll use this. And if you want your crust and things to be light, do not pack your flour. That's how you do it. If you pack this down or shake it down, like if you have a liquid measuring cup and you start shaking it, you're packing that flour down, which is going to make your crust heavy. And you want a light, flaky crust, then it makes a hit with the family and everybody. Okay, now it would like us to add 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Now, you could use iodized salt, but I am going to be using kelp, which is a natural salt. It has less sodium in it, it has more vitamins, and it's very, very high in iodine. which you need for your eyes. So that's a good thing. Now, I will add a tablespoon of wheat germ because it's got the B vitamins and stuff in it, which I've talked about, and minerals. I'll show you other things that you can also use as a substitute as well. And 2 tablespoons of powdered milk, that has your calcium in it, and it adds, actually, it makes your desserts with more protein. That's why I only add so much so it doesn't interfere with the flavor, but yet you get that extra protein you're looking for. Would like 1/3 of a cup of chilled shortening. Now you could use lard or shortening if you wish. I am going to use shortening. And 1/3 of a cup is also 5 tablespoons and 1 teaspoon. So I'll just measure it out like that. Now, without handling this anymore than you have to, you're going to work the shortening in. You just keep working it in with your pastry cutter. If you don't have a pastry cutter, they say 2 knives, but I find it very hard, so I think a couple of dollars for a pastry cutter would make your job a lot easier. See how crumbly the pastry is? All right, now we're going to be adding 2.5 tablespoons of ice water. Since it's winter, believe you me, my cold water's cold. So I'm just going to run it at the faucet. But if it's hot, put some ice cubes in some water and let it get cold while you're putting all this together. And it'll be really, really ice cold. And only add 1 tablespoon and work it in. Do not add it all at once. If you do, you'll mess it up. You have to work it in. And you'll see how it comes together very, very nicely. Now we're going to add 1 tablespoon. They want 1/2 tablespoon. Now that's 1.5 teaspoons. If you don't know it, it's just 1.5 teaspoons. As you can see, we're not handling the paste, the flour that's going to be, flour mixture that's going to be the pastry. The pastry cutter is doing all the work for us in this aspect. Okay, now you're going to take it off your pastry cutter. You're going to get some plastic wrap, because what I'm going to do is put this in the shape of a disc, and it's going in the refrigerator to chill. It's got to chill, and that's what we're going to do. Gently gather it up. I'm rolling it into a ball, and then I'm going to sit there and put it into a disc shape. And it also picks up any extra pastry in the bowl. Flatten it out to a disc. I'm going to put this in the refrigerator to chill. I'll see you in about 1 hour. We're going to leave the pie plate is already set. We're going to wait for that. Then we're going to sit there and take care of the crust. Then we'll take care of the filling then. See you then. Okay, it's sat long enough in the refrigerator. Now we're just sitting. Excuse me, I got the hiccups. We're going to preheat the oven to 400 degrees. Make sure your shelf is in the middle of the oven. Now the reason that you sit there and you chill the dough for the crust is you want the shortening. It's real soft at the time when you're making it, but this gives it a chill so it holds instead of getting mushy and flat. You'll get that flakiness that you're looking for. Now because we need a 9-inch pie plate, we have to roll this circle into an 11-inch. That will give us an inch all the way around, more than bring it right up to the edges. And so you don't want to do so much rolling. You can pat this out to a point and turn it, make sure it doesn't stick, so you won't have as much rolling with the rolling pin, and it'll hold it, have a better shape of a circle. And that's where I'm patting it out a bit, so I won't have as much rolling to do. And if it sticks, I'm just going to throw more flour underneath it, keep it going. See, we already have it pressed out, and we're at 7, and we only have to get to 11. You see? So you won't have as much rolling to do. gonna tell you it's easy doing this. It's not. You see, your rolling pin is 10 inches, so you only have to go about an inch past it. This crust is going to give me a time today. You can always tell when you have a crust. Some crusts are just going to give you a time no matter what you do, no matter how you treat it, it's going to give you a problem. I can see this one wants to split. Adding the powdered milk and stuff makes it a little harder to roll out. You see, it's just about where it has to be, so. Work this with my hands. I'm not going to have an easy time. Always tell when you get a crust that's going to give you a time. This one's going to give me a time. That means I'm not going to have an easy time of preparing it. All right. I got it. All right, I need a paring knife to cut excess off. Because I have a low side right here. And I have extra here, so I'll cut it off here, and I'll be patching that up. I do have some edges that I have to work.
you're patching up, you make sure that you only put water on one side of the piece that you're putting there so it can make a stick. If you don't, it's not going to stick right. Then we'll work it in. See, these are tricks that we had to learn as little girls in the kitchen. That's the only way you're going to be able to learn these. You can't walk into a kitchen and say, oh, I know what I'm doing. It's not easy. I'm pushing from behind the crust because I have dough right on the edge of the pie plate. I'll show you in a minute. What I do is I pull the crust away from this edge here, which gives it more for a flute so I can make a design. Okay? Let's see, how do I want to do this one? Let's see if I can get a fork and do this. Do, do, do. I took the edge of this and I pressed at a 45 degree angle and I made that little design. You see? You have things around. Now, if you get a crack down here at the bottom, take your hands very gently and squeeze it back together. Very, very carefully, and that you don't make another hole. That's very, very important, okay? Now they want us to prick the dough with a fork, okay? Prick the edges. You see how I've done that? Very carefully. Now they want us bake the crust until lightly golden, 10 to 15 minutes. Alright? And they don't want any foil or anything in this one. I don't know why. This is what they're saying. Okay. So I'll see you then when I clean up. Okay, that crust is almost done, but they want us now to, we're going to be preparing the filling. So what they want us to do is they want to hull 3 pints of ripe strawberries. Now when you hull the strawberries, go in at a 45 degree angle close to where the leaves are, hooked up to the strawberry. Just go around in a circle and you just take a tiny little piece off. Don't take too much. Instead of just cutting it off the top and wasting the strawberry, like this, you just go right in here where it hooks up and just go around in a circle. And what you do is make a little cone and that's it. These are really ripe and they want ripe, and what I'm going to have to do with them. So I don't mind. They recommend not to get them wet until you're just ready to use them because they rot very quickly. I don't think it's quickly as they say, but you know, that's what they're saying. So I knew I was going to use these strawberries right away. I didn't want them green, I wanted them ripe. They had these really ripe, so I said, good, I can take them, I'll get full flavor, because my strawberries are not up. They haven't even come out of their sleep yet. But see, you just make a little round cap. Garden yet either. crush enough berries to make one cup. Okay? So I'm going to chop these up a bit, and then I'm going to crush them. And see what we get out of them. Now they want this crust to cool completely. At least that's what it's reading. So we have to let it cool completely. I doubt it would be cool completely, but anyway, we're just waiting this last minute. Did pretty good. Okay, let's see. Okay, we got one cup. All right. Now in a saucepan, we're going to put 3/4 a cup of sugar.
then want 3 tablespoons of cornstarch. Okay, I need a measure. Well, I can use this. I'm going to add your strawberries into it. And you are going to add 1/2 cup of cold water. Too much out. Now we are going to bring this over medium heat, stirring constantly until the mixture becomes to a boil. Then you're going to reduce the heat to low and cook for 2 minutes. What I love about this one recipe, it's not gelatin and stuff. This is actual full strawberries from one into another, so that's good. I've had it many different ways, but this recipe I really like because it is strawberries from end to end. Knowing me, if I don't use all these strawberries, I'm going to slice some strawberries up just enough and make strawberry muffins. It's another recipe, and that would be nice for breakfast tomorrow morning because we're almost done with the nutty carrot muffins, which are delicious. They just grab them and, you know, munch on them. So I might make strawberry muffins tomorrow, but they want strawberries frozen. I can freeze my own strawberries. That's no big deal. I'll just slice them and then freeze them up. See, I would have added powdered milk into the crushed strawberries, but then it would lighten it up and it wouldn't have that rich flavor that we're looking for with the strawberries. Though it's pink, but I knew if I added it into the crust, we would get it there. we get the strawberry ready. When you put it in the bowl, you know what? Put a tablespoon of butter in. I'm not going to put it in the bowl and stir it. I'm going to stir it here in the hot pot. The butter into it. One tablespoon of butter stir into it. And then we'll move it to the bowl and take care of the strawberries. They want me to lay strawberries in here. I've got all sizes and shapes. One thing I hate about buying strawberries and not picking them from the garden is they're green and you can leave them in the house ripening up. But when you get them fresh from the yard, oh my God, you just pick them and eat them. They are just so good. They got such beautiful flavor. Okay, now they want us to pour this over it. I'm sure that's exactly what they want me to do. Now once we pour this over this, my glasses are falling up. Let's pour it all over the strawberries. That's what they want.
This is it. This is the pie. Right here. And it's got to cool.
I said for a good 2 hours. Chilled. Why can't I not get it in the refrigerator?
Because it's too hot. But that's how you make a strawberry pie. And it tastes really good. Take care. Bye-bye.